Hello everyone. Today I'm going to be showing you how to paint your emotions. I saw some dude how to draw your emotions and I was like, I can elevate that. So the first thing you want to do is get a canvas. So I already painted my emotions once on this. So I'm just going to flip it to the back because I don't really like this one, which is also a helpful tip for you guys. So I just want to get this thing out of the way. Hey, and now what you want is a little container of water, a brush, at least one. Okay, so once you have your cup of water and your brush, then you also want to get some paints. These ones are kind of expensive, so you can use a cheaper brand or cheaper kind if you want, but I'm just gonna get all the rainbow colors and all colors that just naturally draw me to them. I have the bottom of a paint palette that I'm gonna use for this. I'm really excited about it. So what you wanna do is you don't even think
about it.
Just go for it, you know? So I'm just gonna paint down, red called my name, so I'm gonna put down red. Don't even think about it, okay, just go. Ooh, that's watery, ugh. Okay, so now we have our red. Ignore the paint that was there before. We have our red. And I honestly am going for some black vibes right now. So, those are the two colors that called my name first. And we're just gonna kind of set up a base with those. Now, you can't expect anything. You just have to let your emotions free, you know, so. And sometimes you can draw something and then think about what it is later. So this, I already have an idea of what this is. So now I'm gonna use my black and elaborate. So I'm gonna let you guess what it is, but there's a star. Okay, so I drew a person. So this is their bones. That's their spine. I think they have some pretty bad scoliosis. So now I'm gonna add the face, but I don't want the face to be red or blue. I want it to be orange, because that's the first thing I thought of, you know? Instinct. Instinct. Okay. Now I'm just gonna leave this on my brush because it will leave a nice multicolored effect, you know?
Okay, now let me fill some of the time with some spoken word poetry. Here we go. Tomato. You were red. Potato. I was not red. Potato and tomato. Rhyme. They should fit, but they don't. Too bad. I turned you into some pasta freaking sauce. Thank you.
Okay, so now I have the pumpkin outline and I think I'm gonna add some purple for shading. And now you may be like, what?
Woof woof, says the doggy. But doggy cannot actually talk. Oh, how sad doggy is, but you do not know. Because doggy cannot talk. Poor doggy. All he wants to do is talk. He wants to say hello. I'm doggy, and not just woof woof. Doggy is sad. Thank you. Do you ever think about how skeletons are just like the bones of humans? Because I do. Thank you.
There is our pet. He's a little rabbit. And I gave him to my skeleton man because he's sad, so I gave him a rabbit. There we go. So it's starting to get a little chaotic, but that's why we're going to color the bones in with another color now. I really like this green.
If you have a big tub and you're filling it with sand, at one point there will be one grain too many of sand. That's like so weird, because you think, no, there's no way. But at some point you would add just one grain on and be like, no, too much.
And we're going to let that dry, and then we're going to add a layer in chalk pastel. Because that's what I'm feeling. So again, do whatever calls your name. This one calls my name. See some of the metallic still. So there we go. And this just really shows what's in my soul. So, hope you enjoy. And comment down below if you know what this means.